Hey, I'm David Ruggiero. I'm so happy to be at the Book Fest again, and I'm here for a particular reason. After many, many decades, I've written a new cookbook, A Tomato Grows in Brooklyn. I mean, take a close look at this. It's a beautiful, beautiful book. It took me a year and a half to write, and this is really a love letter to Brooklyn. I was lucky enough to grow up in Brooklyn during the 60s and 70s. Most of us in Brooklyn were Southern Italians, and very similar to all over the country, to all you other Southern Italians. This is really a lot of funny stories, great characters, but great recipes. Now, today I'm going to do a recipe from the book that is so simple. And sometimes it's said the simplest things are the hardest things to do. All you Italians that are out there watching now know garlic and oil, linguine with garlic and oil. We grew up with this, right? For you people that are not Italian, you've watched it. It's a very easy dish to do, but it's an easy dish to do wrong. So let me show you what we got here. Of course, we start garlic and olive oil. We start with garlic. Please, please, don't buy peeled garlic or these garlic chopped in the jar or something. That's not garlic. That's garbage, okay? So what we did was I peeled the garlic, and what we're gonna do for this recipe, right? Now, this recipe goes so fast that I am going to start by putting, I got linguine here, okay? And I'm gonna put it in salted water, all right? And when I say salted, you put a fair amount of salt in there, and you drop the macaroni in, give it a nice little stir. Now, as this is cooking away, we're gonna do the dish. So we go back to our garlic, and what you wanna do is just slice the garlic, okay? This was a dish that when we were kids, we were teenagers and so forth, at a spur of the moment, we needed something to eat. We came home late at night or so forth. My grandmother would get up and whip this up. This would be one of the dishes she'd whip up. And here I have extra virgin olive oil, okay? And don't be afraid to put a fair amount. Don't be a cheapskate. Go out and get a good quality extra virgin olive oil. And you want to start to heat up. Now what we're gonna do is, as that's heating up, I'm gonna put the garlic in. I'm gonna let it start to cook. All right, now as that's cooking, I want to show you the next ingredient that we're going to use. These are anchovy fillets. These particular ones were in oil, okay? I know a lot of people out there are going to go, ooh, I don't like anchovy, this and that. Trust me, it's not going to be fishy in the dish. And if you have guests coming over that might not like the anchovy, don't tell them it's in it. They'll never know the difference. But what it does do, it adds a wonderful, deep, rich flavor to the linguine. Now, the other thing I'm gonna add, there's not a lot of ingredients here. This is, you go to your local store, this they call crushed red hot pepper. This I just picked out of my garden. This is the fresh version of this. So for that today, I'm gonna use the fresh one, okay? And what I do is, with seeds and all, I just chop that pepperoncini, fresh pepperoncini, okay? Now, let's go and take a look. Here, the garlic is cooking. Now, don't be afraid to lightly color the garlic. People get ridiculous when they're cooking garlic and they're afraid that they're gonna burn the garlic and this and that. You need to cook the garlic. The garlic needs to get lightly golden brown in color. Here, what I'm gonna do now is add that anchovy fillet. Now, as I saute this anchovy fillet with the garlic, take a look there. You're gonna see it start to disintegrate. Now, let me tell you something. People that think that this is just maybe too simple for their guests coming over, you can also do wonderful things with this recipe. You can throw shrimp in there, you can throw in chicken, stuff like that. It's a great thing for other pastas. So here, on garlic cooking nice, on macaroni is cooking away. Okay? Give it a stir once in a while, otherwise it's all going to stick together. Now what I'm going to do is, I'm going to throw that fresh pepperoncini inside. Okay? And you want that to cook. And this is a typical recipe that you're going to find in the book, what we grew up with in Brooklyn. I mean, now look at this. I want you to take a look how it's nicely colored. Okay? Now, you want it to color, right? But your macaroni is not quite there yet. So what you're going to do is take a little bit of the pasta water, and you're going to put the pasta water in. And what that does right now is it stops the garlic from cooking any further. Because you want it to color, but you don't want it to burn. Here I got fresh Italian parsley, and you're just going to roughly chop that. Okay? If you can't get fresh Italian parsley, don't put dry. Don't put anything. Better off you don't put anything. And we're just going to throw that right in the pot. Okay? Now, Southern Italians, particularly the Sicilians and the Calabrians and so forth, back in the day where this dish originated, did not have access to Parmigiana or pecorino cheese and so forth. So years and years ago, they used to finish the dish not with cheese, but with breadcrumb. So I'm going to use this breadcrumb I love, lightly toasted in the saute pan, okay? And I'm going to incorporate this into the dish. Now, let's go back over here. Look how nice this is. Look at the colors there. Beautiful. Now, very important, when you're doing macaroni like this, dry, when you're cooking dry pasta, is to let the pasta cook 3/4 of the way in the water. This is a mistake a lot of people do. And then that last quarter, you want it to cook and finish the cook in the pan. Reason being is that you want that pasta to absorb all the flavors. You know, the worst thing in the world is when you see people take the pasta from the water, put it in a dish and throw some water and sauce on top. Forget about it. That's terrible. What you want to do is you want it to finish cooking in this pan, right? And what I'm going to do is, it's going to absorb the flavors of the garlic, and what you want to do is add more of that pasta water there. It's going to help it to finish cooking, and it's going to help it to absorb all those wonderful flavors. Look at this. I wish you could smell it. I got the cats and dogs barking outside and meowing. They want to come in and have a little macaroni here. So here, you let this cook. It's absorbing. Now what I do is, if it's a macaroni, a pasta, that you're going to add cheese to, you never add cheese with the flame on. You shut the flame off and you add the cheese off the flame. You don't want to cook cheese, whether you're using Parmigiana or pecorino, because you change the texture. There's oils that are released from the cheese, and it's not good. For this particular pasta, I call for pecorino, which is a sheep's milk cheese. It's sharper. It stands up to the flavors. You got very strong, bold flavors here with the hot pepper and the garlic. It stands up very, very well to it. So here comes that little bit of breadcrumb I put in, okay? It's going to help it too. It's going to add a very nice texture to the pasta. I got my nice plate here, right? Look at this, how nice this is coming. This sings of Southern Italy. It sings of Brooklyn. This is, we grew up with this in Brooklyn. And now, what you want to do is take that pasta. Oh boy, I wish you guys were all here. This is the real deal. This is no monkey business here. With that garlic, with all those things there, look at that. Oh boy. Now, a little bit more breadcrumb, okay? Don't go crazy. You're not making a chicken cutlet. And then, this is a pecorino, all right? And what we're gonna do is, this particular brand's called Locatelli. It's one of my favorites. And don't buy pre-grated in the store. Do it fresh, as is, because there's nothing like it. It is just the wonderful when you do it like this. Here, look at this. Don't be cheap with the cheese. Give lots of cheese there. Oh my God. Delicious, delicious. And that, my friends, is what you call Italian-American from Brooklyn, direct from Brooklyn. Remember, I do have a buy. I got lots of grandchildren to feed, so buy the book, go out there, run on. It's everywhere. It's Amazon, Target, Barnes & Noble, all the bookstores, this and that. Lots of great recipes like this. This is a very easy recipe for you to do at home. And